Hey VC, this is Carlos from As the Table Turns. Wanted to do a little unboxing video. Just got some stuff in today that I've ordered over the past few weeks, and it all came in today. So yeah, just wanted to go through some stuff. It's gonna be some jazz, some country, some folk, and some soul. Soul and funk. Mix. We'll go through the first one here. Kind of shout out the different places that I bought this stuff from. So this one is from the Turntable Store on Discogs. They just had a nice selection of folk and also some harmony duos. So anyway, I wanted to. Liked all that stuff, so I wanted to kind of get some of that. All right, so first one we got here is Great Original Recordings by the Carter Family. A lot of songs that I don't know, but just thought this looked like a nice compilation of some stuff that I thought would be good. So anyway, Carter Family, Beginnings of Country right here. Got that. Next we have, well, Carter Family again. Mid the Green Fields of Virginia. Awesome. Well, got a glare on that. Mid the Green Fields of Virginia. The Carter Family, Sarah, Maybelle, and A.P. Carter. A collection of original recordings of famed country songs. Let's see what we got on here. Keep on the Sunny Side. So this one has some more recognizable songs. Keep on the Sunny Side, The Winding Stream, The Clinch Mountain Home, Bury Me Under the Weeping Willow. Let's see. Think Picture on the Wall. I know that one. So some nice old folk standards on there. Then we got, I don't have anything by him, but this is Uncle Dave Makem. Macon. Laugh Your Blues Away. Really like some old folk stuff like this, Appalachian folk. So Uncle Dave Macon, he was on the Grand Ole Opry quite a bit. So probably some songs that he sang on there. Take Me Back to My Old Carolina Home. Death of John Henry, from Jerusalem to Jericho. Anyway, lots of good old, once again, folk standards on that. Then we have Monroe Brothers. So Bill Monroe and his brother Charlie. I think Bill and Charlie Monroe. But yeah, just on Bluebird, compilation of. A lot of their songs. Was happy to get this. I think that's Bill right there, and that's his brother Charlie. Bill, Charlie. Got the glare going on. Sorry. On some foggy mountaintop. Let's see here. Darling Corey. The Saints Go Marching In. Weeping Willow Tree. So yeah, once again, some just great old folk standards on this. Got that. Then, oh, I gotta open this other one up. So in here we have the Leuven Brothers, Charlie and Ira. Ira and Charlie. Yeah, so this is one of these harmony duos, close harmony duos. I'll put a link to Elliot Cruz at Lazy Dog Records. He talked about, once again, I talked about this on a previous video, but I'll bring it up again. He talked about and did a series on close harmony duos, mostly brother duos, and so. The Leuven Brothers are one of those, and a very influential harmony duo. Let's see here. Another Leuven Brothers. Let's look at some of the songs. We got no songs that I really know. Yeah, but kind of gospel. This one's more of a, I think, gospel songs. The Gospel Way is one of the songs. So there you go. Really like that. Then I got another gospel, but it's the Delmore Brothers. Great gospel songs by the Delmore Brothers. So another harmony, close harmony duo of these brothers. Let's see. Yeah, just a bunch of gospel, old gospel songs. Gonna Fly Away with Christ, Over in the Glory Land, When the Good Lord Cares, Hallelujah Morning. So awesome collection of some of their stuff. Then I saw this, thought I should pick up this, look pretty cool. Anthology of Country Music, Early Country Harmony, 1930s. So, I mean, this has the Dixon Brothers on it. This has the Delmore Brothers on it, the Crowder Brothers, the Girls of the Golden West, the Blue Sky Boys, who I have already. Let's see, the Carlisle Quartet, the Monroe Brothers are on here. So it just more of the same, but probably songs that aren't on the other tracks or on the other albums. So anyway, and then I got the Dixon Brothers, which are on that compilation as well. So this is the Dixon Brothers Volume 1. So yeah, really cool. Love all that stuff. Look forward to listening to all that. Now, let's see what we got here. Move on to some different type of music. I believe this is soul. Soul, kind of, I don't know, it's all a new neo soul kind of vibe. So this is all Coal Mine. All from Coal Mine. Soul, funk. Really cool. Got a little Coal Mine sticker that they put in there. A little postcard. Says, Iris working on her mixtape during quarantine. I don't know if you can see that. Anyway. All right. Then we got first one, Monophonics. Heard a lot about this, checked it out, really liked it. An original blend of California soul that is psychedelic, cinematic, and classic. Really good. Really good stuff. And then we got, excited about this one, Kelly Finnegan. Once again, some great soul music. The Tales People Tell. Yeah. Really good soul music. Check it out. Coal Mine Records. All right. I already showed the Duran Jones and the Indications on one of my previous videos. And actually, I showed for my first video, which was a contest for Joe at Analog Archive. I was talking about my favorite live album. I didn't have it yet. It was on the way. This is it. So this is the live album that I was talking about. Duran Jones and the Indications Live Volume 1. They do a mix of songs from both of their records. But just really cool. He makes calls out to the crowd. The crowd, really great crowd participation in this record. So yeah, excited to listen to that. And this is their second album, Duran Jones and the Indications, American Love Call. Morning in America, that's a great song. Court of Love. Yeah, this is just another great album by Duran Jones and the Indications. So looking forward to that. This is Delvon Lamar Organ Trio. Didn't really hear this on any of the VC videos, or people show this on the VC videos, but listened to it on Spotify, and looked it up on Coal Mine, and really liked what I heard, so I bought it. Awesome organ in that. And then this was the one that everyone was showing, Black Pumas. So got that in as well. Yeah. So looking forward to hearing that as well. All right. Third and last box. I do have another record that's going to be showing up on Friday, but I wanted to just make this video. It's only one record. Roscoe Holcomb, Close to Home. He's a traditional Appalachian folk, so I have that showing up on Friday. But now we're going to show some jazz. Always cut away from you. Don't cut towards you. That's a tip. It's a tip from me to you. Don't cut towards yourself. All right. So we have just making sure it's not looks kind of a little bent. All right, well, we'll see. We'll open it up. Art Pepper in the rhythm section, or meets the rhythm section. Red Garland, Paul Chambers, Philly Joe Jones. So when you have those guys backing you up, you know, can't go wrong. Really awesome West Coast jazz on this, even though these guys are East Coast guys. It's Art Pepper's record, and he's a West Coast jazz man. So really like this record. Have it on MP3. Now I have it on vinyl. All right, then we got Working, Miles Davis Quintet. Yeah, once again, I mean, he always had a great lineup for his quintet. So these are all OJC copies, original jazz classics, which they do a really good job. I'm told mostly from the original master tapes. So if you get a chance to get these, they're pretty inexpensive. But yeah, Working with the Miles Davis Quintet, John Coltrane, Red Garland, Paul Chambers, Philly Joe Jones. Once again, just a great lineup. Really like this record. And let's get to it. Here, it's down here somewhere. It's the other one that will match that. That is Relaxin' with the Miles Davis Quintet. So I already have Cooking and Steaming. So now I have Relaxin' and Working. So that fills out my of those four albums right there. So really like this album. Very relaxing. relaxing with Miles Davis Quintet. So yeah, it's very, very relaxed, very chill, very cool. Love it. Then I got Sketches of Spain. Really love this album. Forget what, this is just Columbia. This is a Columbia repress mono. One of the newer ones. RTI pressing though. So really cool in mono. Let's go with Chet Baker in New York. Really love Chet Baker. Like I said, I love West Coast jazz. So this is a West Coast jazz man. And has another good lineup here. This has Johnny Griffin on trumpet, Al Haig on tenor sax, Paul Chambers on bass, and Philly Joe Jones on the drums. So once again, I mean, Philly Joe Jones and Paul Chambers, that's your rhythm section. That's a great start for any record. So looking forward to hearing that. We'll go through the whole jazz lineup here. I'll put some other things aside. We'll go look at those a little later. But Birth of the Cool, Miles Davis. Just trying to fill out my Miles Davis. So had to get this one. Really love Jerry Mulligan is on this. I mean, this is a what, nonet? Yeah, Birth of the Cool was a nonet, so nine players. But Jerry Mulligan was very instrumental in this record, helping Miles form. Jerry Mulligan was a composer. He composed lots of different things for different artists, so but he helped Miles Davis out a lot with this. Another Miles Davis, mono, RTI premium pressing, Kind of Blue. Had to get this one, you know, this is an essential. Didn't have it yet, so wanted to get that. Glad I got it. And last, Miles Davis. This is definitely later on in his career. This is, you know, several records later. This is once he changed his sound. Totally different sound from all the other records that I have. But yeah, this is, this feels, it's super moody. Super moody, super intense, dark sounding. If you've never heard Bitches Brew, great. But it's definitely different than any of the other stuff that you hear from Miles Davis that came before. I mean, there's definitely records that you can spot the changes going on along the way. This is right after A Silent Way. Anyway, really good record. Got Sonny Clark, Cool Strutton. Once again, great lineup here. Art Farmer, Jackie McLean, Paul Chambers, Philly Joe Jones, and Sonny Clark, of course, on piano. But yeah, really love that cover. This is the Blue Note 75th anniversary edition. So not a Tone Poet, not the 80th anniversary, but you know, I wanted to get it, and that is a super hard one to find, trying to get it in any other form. The other two records that I kind of just added on top, I really needed to start filling out my country, so I got Johnny Cash at Folsom Prison. So that's a necessity. I think it's like one of the most popular records ever purchased all the time. People just keep that in stock because they know it's going to sell. And then Sly and the Family Stone, Greatest Hits. So we needed to fill out some more soul funk stuff from... I got some new soul funk kind of stuff in, but I needed to kind of do a backtrack and get some older stuff. I have, you know, Al Green And I forget who else I have. But I need to pick up some Otis Redding. I need to pick up some James Brown. I need to pick up, you know, a lot of different artists. Curtis Mayfield. I need to get some of that stuff. But wanted to get this, so got it. All right. So that is my unboxing. If you like what you see, please subscribe. Comment below. Tell me what I did wrong. Tell me what I did right. Anyway, thank you for tuning in, and I will hopefully be making another video here pretty soon. Probably be making another DVD video, because I left out some DVDs, and I just bought about 6 or 7 new DVDs for my music DVD collection. Anyway, all right. Thank you. This is Carlos from As the Table Turns. Talk to you guys later. Bye.